Since I've been a kid, I've had an interest in inorganic chemistry. I mean, I remember, you know, I had my first chemistry set when I was 9 years old. Got into all sorts of mischief and misadventures doing chemistry. I have three sort of overarching research interests. The first is in the area of sonochemistry. That's the application of high-intensity ultrasound to do chemical reactions and chemical catalysis. The second is in making supramolecular complexes that can be used as optoelectronic circuit components. And then the third area is chemical education research. Besides all the university committees, one of the things that I do is that I advise six different student organizations, or have advised a variety of organizations, including Habitat for Humanity. I've been their advisor since 1994. Mortar Board, Catholic Student Association, Cairo, the Graduate Chemistry Graduate Student Organization, and the American Chemical Society Student Affiliate. And in terms of outreach to the community, I've done over 250 demo shows. Sometimes I dress up as a wizard, so they'll call it a chemical magic show. Although the American Chemical Society really would prefer us not to give people the impression that chemistry is magic, because it's not. It's based on firm scientific principles. But nonetheless, it's a lot of fun, especially for younger people. So I've done demo shows from age 3 to age 93, very literally. So over 250 shows to over 30,000 people. I've done some radio and TV spots as well. And so, once again, the idea is to reach as broad an audience as possible and try to convince them that chemistry is really fun, exciting, and it's something they can do, and it's accessible. To me, that's, you know, one of the joys of being a faculty member, is that I can share my enthusiasm for what I like to do with a broader audience, and maybe show them, yeah, that's why it should be cool for me too. I really like what the philosopher Eric Hoffer had to say. He said, even in the most humblest of jobs, you can find interesting things to do and interesting things to think about. And so I find my inspiration every day just by living and by observing people, by being in the place that I'm in the moment and thinking about what I'm doing. If I want to think more globally and long-term, I get my inspiration, I think, largely from looking at problems that are facing society, or problems that I think I can solve, or that I have some possible interesting solutions to. And as you can imagine, it's fun to come into work every day, because there's always something new going on, and you never know what we're going to discover.